Hello, my name's Donna Spencer and I'm a website and application designer with a bit of a specialisation around information architecture and navigation design. Today we're going to do a deep dive into navigation, looking at horizontal navigation bars for large screen. That might sound like a really detailed topic, but I promise there's more to it than you think. A horizontal navigation bar is usually used at the top of the screen. It's often referred to as top navigation or a menu bar. This kind of navigation is good when you have a small number of top-level categories that can fit across the screen even when people increase their fonts or zoom in, where they don't change very often, and where the labelling uses quite short terminology. While these things can actually wrap, you don't want them wrapping over more than about two lines. If your sitemap isn't quite like this, for example, if it's something that changes over time, uses long terminology, you're probably better with a vertical navigation menu. The horizontal navigation bar itself can be used for up to two levels of the hierarchy. In this case, the second level needs to have the same kind of characteristics as the first. That is, it still needs to be able to fit on the screen. The way it works is that when you select a top-level item, an additional bar appears with the second level, and users then click on the second-level item to navigate to a page. Note, you need to remember to specifically include an item in the navigation bar that represents that first-level page. The reason is on touch screens, when you tap the level one item, it shows the second level of navigation. If you want to go to that actual page, then you have to tap that page. Here the example is the all accessories link. I mention this as if you've designed for desktop before, you can actually set it up so you would hover to show the navigation and click the top level item to get to the page. But that doesn't work on touch screens. It's a bit clumsy, and I mention it because every single time I design navigation, I have to remember to do this. Horizontal navigation bars just don't really work for a third level. They just get too confusing. It's too hard to see where you are and what's going on here. You've probably seen tab navigation on websites. The curly corners of tabs and the straight lines of navigation bars are exactly the same. Tabs are just one way of displaying the top level. So the same characteristics go for both. Another way of showing the second level of the sitemap is with a drop-down. These are simple and common. They're very good for flexibility when you might need to add and remove items. They're good when you have more items than you could fit in a horizontal bar, and they're good when you have long titles. They're also good for short lists and short titles. You can have the drop-down appear when somebody hovers their mouse or after clicking. Hovering only works for desktop, of course. It needs to be clicked for a touchscreen. Again, remember to include an item at the top of the drop-down for that level one page and the way it works for both hovering and clicking. Drop-downs can extend one more level with a flyout, but don't go more than one level. Three is plenty. Here's another way of adding more levels to your navigation. See, I told you there was more to this than you thought. Mega menus are like crazy big drop-downs. They're good for large sites where the second and third level might have many items, where those items might have long titles. They're also very flexible, so good when the navigation might change often. I really like them for things like catalog sites where I can show the main way the content is organized, as well as alternate ways of accessing it. These really need to be organized visually quite carefully so that people can understand what they're looking at. You can use the second level headings and third levels for lists, or if you have a really long list, you can break it up into sections visually. Like dropdowns, mega menus can be triggered with a hover or a click, and you'll need to make sure you include a link to that level one page as well. So, a top navigation bar is good when you have a small number of categories that can fit across the screen, that don't change very often with relatively short terminology. You can then extend the top navigation bar with another horizontal bar, a drop-down, or a mega menu. With these examples, you might still be thinking, but my website has four or more levels. How do I design for that? You can use a combination of horizontal and vertical navigation, of course. So take a look at the video for vertical navigation as well. You might use horizontal navigation for the first two levels and then vertical navigation for the rest.